I pray that you give me the strength and guidance that I need to do so. Who's there?
I've said dig. Start digging. We don't have all night.
Anita cannot attain her degree and get a nursing job. It cannot happen.
Hi, I'm happy to see you here again for part 2. Please click on the link above if you're yet to watch part 1. So, the strategies we talked about in part 1 are those used to prevent you from praying in the first place. Now let's look at the strategies that the devil uses to block the answers to your prayers. James, is that you?
Ah, Anita. I didn't know that you work here. How is it going?
I'm okay, just a bit tired from work. As you can see, I'm always on my feet, and this is quite tiring. But I'm now used to it.
But I'm curious, how were you not able to eat during this 3-day fast that we concluded? You are surrounded by so much food and all these goodies.
You have always been funny, James. The food has not been the problematic for me. What I've struggled with is a lot of fatigue. I was too tired to pray, and I eventually stopped the fast on day 3.
Wow, so you didn't complete the whole program?
No, I feel guilty about it. But I decided that I will just wait for the next corporate fast, and try again. Anita. Coming. I really need to get back to work.
What you've told me is troubling me. Can I talk to you about it later on?
Sure. In fact, my break is in the next 30 minutes.
Okay, I will wait, so that we can have a chat about what you've just told me.
I now understand. So what I was going through was just to prevent me from praying?
Yes, they are subtle tactics, but they actually prevent you from praying. And you really don't need to wait for the next corporate fast. You can fast by yourself. I just thought that I should let you know.
Thanks a bunch. It now makes a lot of sense.
Anyway, let me go back to work. I'll see you later.
Let me pray today while standing up, just like James advised me to. Heavenly Father, I come before you in absolute submission to your will. O Lord, you know my desire to go back to university to acquire my degree. I pray that you give me the strength and guidance that I need to do so.
Our strategy to make Anita too tired to pray has failed. It's a miracle that she has managed to finish her prayers as of late. We cannot allow this to continue happening. But hasn't her prayer already been answered? What do you suggest we now do? I think I know what we shall do. We have to try another way. Anita cannot attain her degree and get a nursing job. It cannot happen.
This looks like a graveyard. I suddenly don't feel so good.
Dig.
Who's there?
I've said dig. Start digging. We don't have all night.
Who are you, and why am I here?
No more questions. You are here to bury your degree certificate.
I feel so tired, and kinda confused. I wonder why.
+70+55. This makes no sense.
What's wrong, Fred?
This cash doesn't add up. Did you bill that lady who has just left? Because there's a chunk of cash that is not here.
Yes, I did. She paid for everything before she left.
I see. Ask Tom to come here right away.
All right.
Sir, you asked to see me. You and I are the only ones who have access to the cash register. $500 is missing. Tell me where it went to?
Oh, I don't know, Fred. I really don't know. Go to the back right now.
I will search everybody myself. So do you all think that I will entertain a thief working for me?
This is unacceptable.
The fact that the CCTV cameras haven't been working for the past week doesn't give anyone the mandate to steal from me.
It's great to have you back, Doreen. How are you feeling? Much better. I was sick for almost a whole week. By the way, can I borrow your hand cream? I forgot mine at home and my hands are really ashy. Sure, it's in my handbag. Go ahead and get it. I need to be quick and stash this bundle of cash into Anita's bag.
Doreen had discovered a loophole in the cashier system, which was managed by Tom and their boss Fred. She has been stealing money for the past week. She now knows that she's about to get caught with the cash, so she decided to plant it in Anita's bag.
Anita, you are next. What is this? A bundle of cash.
That's not mine.
So what is it doing in your handbag? It's the exact amount that's missing from the register.
I don't know. I don't know what to say. Oh no. It was you, wasn't it, Doreen? Stop blaming me for your actions, woman. I was not there when you stole the cash. Is this why you asked for my hand cream, so that you could do this to me? What piece of a person are you? You don't know whom you have rattled. Rattled? So you are like a rattlesnake now, aren't you? This behavior fits you well.
Enough. You are both suspended, until I find out who is guilty of this. And you, Anita, you are lucky that I haven't called the cops on you. Now get out.
But sir, I didn't do it.
Get out before I change my mind.
Ariel has been a true friend to me. When I found myself unable to even pay for my rent, she took me into her home and accommodated me. But I don't know how long she will continue to do this, to be honest, Mom. I have tried getting another job, but it has been one disappointment after the other. I don't like seeing you suffer, Anita. Why don't you come back and live in the countryside with me, until you have found another job? I unfortunately will have to consider that option. My business has been so slow of late. I seriously don't know how I am going to survive with Anita being jobless in my house. I love Anita like a sister, but it might be time to ask her to move out. I just cannot continue supporting her, because I am also hurting. So, as you have seen so far, the devil fights answers to your prayers, harder than anything else. In Anita's case, the devil knew that Anita wanted to earn her degree, so that she could become a nurse. However, the devil knew that by taking away her job, she would not have a chance to actualize her dream. The first strategy the devil uses to fight your breakthroughs is through dream pollution. He will send you negative dreams to pollute your spirit man, so that you are eligible to receive your breakthrough in the waking life. Bad dreams that have not been cancelled leads to stagnancy. If this doesn't work, he will then provoke others to bring feelings of anger, bitterness, and unforgiveness in your life. You will find yourself fighting with other people over your frustrations, and the devil is well aware that God doesn't like this. It's written in Ephesians 4:27, that we should not give the devil a foothold, due to our anger. The final strategy that the devil may use to block your breakthroughs, is by attacking your destiny helpers. Either your helpers will want nothing to do with you, or they will become afflicted, in case they help you. So how do you counter the devil's attacks? The first one is by doing warfare prayer, persistently. But I want to talk about a strategy that most Christians rarely use. and that is praise and worship. When you worship God, it shows pure submission to Him. This also uplifts your spirit, especially when worn out from warfare prayers. When your praises go up, blessings must come down. Learn to use praise and worship hand in hand with your warfare prayers. Yes, I have prayed, Mom, but I will pray just like you have advised me to. Do I do the praise and worship at the end of my prayers? Yes, and do it often, as well. Okay, thank you so much, Mom. I will talk to you later.
Okay, my daughter.
My mom has a point. Let me try to pray before Ariel comes back from the market. Heavenly Father, I come before you today, thanking you for the advice and assistance that I have received. I repent of any sins that I have committed in the past, specifically the sins done out of anger, and I ask for your forgiveness, Lord. I cover myself by the blood of Jesus as I get into these prayers. I command every evil cover or evil cloud that is hovering over my life to catch fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I erase, by the blood of Jesus, any evil decree or handwriting that is blocking my promotion in Jesus' name. I command every evil shrine or altar that is speaking negative decrees into my life to be consumed by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. I blind the eyes of any monitoring agent monitoring my plans and aspirations in order to frustrate my life in Jesus' name. I renounce, reject and nullify every evil covenant that I have made knowingly or unknowingly, whether in my dreams or the physical realm, in the name of Jesus. I command every evil powers feeding me in my dreams or erasing my dreams to be bound and paralyzed in Jesus' name. I cover all my dreams by the blood of Jesus. I command every strong man or powers holding back my possessions or answered prayers in the realm of the Spirit to release them now and be paralyzed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. O God, release your warring angels to recover and take back all my stolen opportunities and blessings, wherever they are have been hidden by a strong man, in Jesus' name. I decree and declare, O God, according to Joel 2:25, that you have restored to me all the years that the locust, cankerworm, caterpillar and palmer worm have eaten, in Jesus' name. I rejoice in you, Lord, always, and again I say rejoice. I thank you for your answered prayers. I thank you for the victory you have given me. I thank you for delivering me from the hands of my enemies, in Jesus' name. You are worthy of praise, and all glory goes to you, God. It's in Jesus' name that I have prayed, amen.
What was that? The monitors that we had put on this girl, Anita, have all been broken. What? How is that possible? Your time is up. I'm here to collect all of Anita's blessings that you have withheld from her. No, never. My Lord is a consuming fire.
What's this? Your application for enrollment at the National School of Nursing has been approved. Please visit our campus to submit your full details at our registration office. Oh wow! Finally! I have been applying for years, with no response. But how am I going to afford to pay for my course, when I don't have any job? Hello?
Am I speaking to Anita Jefferson?
Yes, this is she.
My name is Ruben, calling you from Tyke Company. I'm calling with regards to the interview that you attended last week.
Yes, Mr. Ruben.
I'm pleased to let you know that you have been awarded with the position. Please visit our offices before Friday this week to collect your appointment letter.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm so grateful for this opportunity.
You're most welcome, Anita.
Yes, I almost cannot believe this. Double portion is my possession. Oh, thank you, Lord.